Today, I will show you how to use a serger bladder to roll hem like this. You see the hem? You see the hem? I show you this side too. Okay, I will get the water soluble. This is a wash and gone, Pelon wash and gone 541. I use this with the thin fabric. Okay, I will cut like one line like this. Maybe just. Just one line, one long line, like this, okay? So you got this one, and then you cut the fabric. You don't need to measure, okay? So, if you're not good in measuring and you're not good in use a pin, you be my friend, okay? Here, really sheer. They have a short side and long side. And this fabric, I don't think that it have a problem with you that you cut in any side. So this thin fabric don't have any stretchy. So the stretchy is the same. What side you want to cut is what side you want the pattern to be. I will cut long side because of I want to gathering it later on. I will cut on 3 inch, okay? 3 inch. So I will cut a long line 3 inch. Well, start long line 3 inch. Again, no measuring. And here, because of on this page, I have the 3 inch here. So I just put the fabric down and measure here. Done. So I get one piece. Okay, this one is just. So I get one piece of thin fabric and one piece of washable, wash and gone, pillow wash and gone, okay? Now let's start. Okay, now, I hope you can see it clear because it's too late night. Before I make the video, I already researched from the site. And the instruction that they give to us in a CD, I make it like this, and I put it in the paper to make sure that I not get it wrong, and I test it one by one, and I mark like this for thread stitch, for woven fabric, and marks in Thai too. So I set the tension and on the side how I have to set the because of I will forget it, right? And you should do too if you have a patient enough, and I think it's good for the beginner to do that. Here, this is the page that we will do it today. The fabric that I tell you is thin, so it should be like a scarf and handkerchief edge hem, right? And also you can use with the children cloth. So in the CD-ROM, they use the stitch number 4, the tension number 4, and number 8 to 7, nearly 8. Do you see that? But I said, I tried already, and the thread is torn out. It's too much tension for me, I think. Maybe you guys work, I don't know, but for me it doesn't work like CD-ROM say. And this is a side, what they say is, they said it should be on 0.7. But for me it should be on 0.721. So it's on 0.85, about this. And here is around 2. It's around 2. And this one is good on 6. Okay. And the tension on the top, I cannot use this. So what I use is, you can use this, you can try. Because they say that, okay, use right needle. So you take off the left needle and remove, don't forget, remove stitch finger. Okay, so I said remove left needle and stitch finger. And then, so this one should be, you can set to 4. This is left needle, so I set to 3.8. And the line needle, they set to 4. I set lower a little bit, 3.8. And they set to 4. And on the upper looper, I set to 3.2. And the last one, lower looper, they set to 7 to 8. I set to what? 6.5. So what I use is 3.8, 3.8, 3.2, and 6.5. This is for the, if you want to roll the edge, the hem, for the scarf, for the thin fabric, okay? Okay, so here we go. I take this up just to put the fabric, okay? Take this part off. And what you have to do is, they have the hand view this side. You put the hand view toward to yourself here. Come to yourself. And you see the needles. The needle is up or not? See? This is needle down, right? So you have to make sure that the needle is up, so you can take the needle easily. I have to take this off because it will not on my way back side. Here, do you see it? This is the back side. So you just use a finger, push it, and it will drop down. You hear? Then, you move this up. And you pull it off. So you can take it off very easily. Slide it, okay? So this one off, this, remember this. Now you see that you want to take the needle off, right? But you still have the thread in like this, and you don't want to, because of you want to take the needle the left side out from your way. So what you have to do is, you put all this, for me, I'll put all this to 0. I put all this to 0. So that you don't have any tension at all. And you use a hand wheel to hand wheel it. And you pull thread out. Hand wheel it, okay? And pull thread. Not pull hard, pull like a lady pull, okay? And then it will come loose, and you pull out. See the thread? Before it's like this, and now it goes straight. And that is what we want.
because I'll be one to pull it out. Okay, hurt. So I cut it. And pull a little bit until it comes straight. Hey, it comes straight now. Well, so you can pull it now, right? Okay, see that? Cut it off. So now, when it loose, you can take it off easily. You see that? If it, so you can take it off one by one, and don't have any problem at all. So take it off one by one. So all thread gone. Now, where? One step past. And what I suggest is, even you take off one needle or any thread in the for loop breaking, any thread breaking, you should thread all that again, thread all four again, because of I try sometimes that if you only thread one, that is break, and it will cause a lot of problem later on, like the stitch is not right and some problem to your soldier. So the good thing, don't be lazy like I do, thread all again. Yeah, and now I will thread all again. See that? So now, one step clear. Take the left off with this. So you have to grab both of them. So you have to grab both of them. And you make it loose from the left to right. Left to right, loose, left to right, okay, left to right, okay, so it come both, but you want the what, left needle out, right, so you keep the right needle with you, left needle out, okay, so right needle put in place, make sure that it in place. And now tie right to left, right to left, right to left, right to left, okay. Again, make sure the needle is in place. Exactly in place, because if not, it will cause the needle broken. So now I think it's in place. Good. How can you know it's right on place? The needle, left needle, should be touched here. You see inside the right needle on the top is touched to the metal plate, if you can see clear, okay, so mean it in place and right. Next, stitch finger. Take off stitch finger. Okay, let's see stitch finger. Stitch finger is here. Let me here. You see it? And here. Here's stitch finger. What you have to do is, don't let it swing. Grab. Do you see this? This one for pushing. This one, you grab one hand, push one hand. Push one hand, grab one hand. It's come right out. Like this. So this time, I will thread only three. I don't thread on the left needle. Start with the upper looper. This one just pulling. And same thing. If you don't know how to thread, see the last video I made. And here, and push through. I will not make it over again, okay? If you don't know how to thread the upper loop, go and check it. If you notice, I still not put this in the foot here, okay? Until I thread finish, so it's not on my way. Second one is the lower loop here. Okay. Up, 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 up. Lower loop. And if you have the leftover thread, just cut off. The previous video is not clear about the lower loop. So this is, I show you the lower loop more closer. The lower loop, you go to the two hook here, right, and pass this number 8, and here just take it off and you just place it, and this another hand you make the thread is, you have a tension, or we have a tension, so it's like in place, and you put it in. Crack, you hear click, and the two dot is go together, and then you use a hand wheel, pull the lower loop higher than the upper loop. You see it? This one. You move the hand wheel toward you until the lower loop is higher than the upper loop. This is upper loop. This is lower loop that we will thread the lower loop, right? Now it's under. We move with the hand wheel. Move toward us, toward me, and then until the lower loop is higher now. Yeah, good. Good now. So like this, when the lower loop higher now, you just thread. This is lower loop, right? Thread it in here. I cannot thread with the camera, so you understand, right? So thread it in here. See now? So when you move again with the hand wheel, you will see that the lower loop is crossed with the upper loop. So the cross is what I mean, like this, okay? It's crossed together, but the lower loop thread is up above the upper loop. Last video is quite not clear, and I maybe cut off too much this part. Okay, so upper lower done. The right needle, okay? Right needle. Red red thread. Do the same thing. Go on the line. I will cut it sharp again. Cut off is easy. You see that? Only one time. You don't need to See, and the hole is so little hole is little, very little. Whip. So now, this is a light needle, right? The left needle, you just take it off, and you pull the three thread together. Good. Okay, on the back, pull to the back. Make sure that not any thread is stick, so you can pull easily. And now the time to put the feet in. So again, you put the feet in, just slide it easily in, and make sure that don't have any thread is stuck on the feet. You see this one stuck now. Take off. So the surgery is really delicate, but I think. So this one is just, you just pull on the back, okay?
3.8 3.2 and 6.5 okay, done. Good. One. Good. On the side is 0.85, so about. Okay, I get this. And 2 and 6. Two. This low hand is 2. And 6. 6. Now you thread with your hand first, okay? And another hand is pull the thread head on the back, to the back. And now you don't have the finger stitch. Make sure you don't have finger stitch. Make sure you don't have the left needle in your thread. And make sure that the needle is not touch something else. And now you put the wash and gone, pillow wash and gone on the top of the fabric that you want to roll him. I always put the wash and gone upper a little to before the fabric arrive the needle. Okay, so it should be like this. Try. And here I use a wash and go that I used for stabilize something before. So this is the piece that left, and you can use it. How it work? Okay, beautiful, beautiful. Can see. Oh, beautiful. Well, not bad, huh? So this one, when you wash, it just goes away. So you use this all the way along. Open it. Okay, when you finish the hem, just cut it off very close, okay? When you finish it, just like this. And make sure that you don't cut the fabric. So. And don't worry, because of all the wash and gone that you left, it will gone when you wash. So you film.
is the film that from Pillar 2. It's a transparency film like this. And normally you put on the top of the applicate. Put on top. Start. How is it? Not better. So let's see result. And when you take off, just pull it. So this is good that you don't need to cut it off. Just pull it and really neat. Really need to and quick. I love this way the most. And you don't need to wash. Okay, need clean.